experience an earthquake?
Mexico City, yeah, so we know about earthquakes.
But do you feel like they did a good depiction of the Bond movie of Mexico City?
I don't know if you knew, but the Day of the Dead parade, it wasn't a thing before the movie.
Wasn't a thing before the movie?
You just earned yourself a detention, sir.
Team Q is already one big detention.
Son of a...
You know, actually, in an odd way of handling it, she's still moving along with life. You know, she's not stuck in bed and depressed. She's, in a good way, has stuff to do. I think that's also why she doesn't immediately go home for the holidays, because I think she's afraid that she's going to slope into a depression. I don't know if there would be any additional advice. I mean, maybe not drink as much or smoke as much.
In some ways, I don't think he's wrong. He just pushes them too far and too harsh. I mean, I think a certain amount of discipline and rigor and stuff like that is good, but he goes too far.
Definitely. Working with young actors, do you feel like the dynamics are different when they are relying on your experience?
I never felt Dominic was relying on me. All I ever did with him, and all I ever did with any of them, was just sort of point out how good they were all the time. If that helped them, great, but I was just sort of enjoying them. So the energy of it, I like it. It's fun. It's a good time. That's amazing. That's very funny. That's awesome.
I can't fail this class.
Oh, don't sell yourself short, Mr. Coates. I truly believe that you can.
Had you read Meditations by Marcus Aurelius before the movie?
No, I didn't.
You should. Yes. It really changed my life, and now I give it away to everyone I hear talking about it, like for real.
Oh, wow. Then I need to read it now.
I liked the fact that the guy did that in the movie. You know what I mean? Like the fact that it was important to him to give it to all these people. It's actually a pretty cool book. It's pretty amazing. Well, I remembered all the sort of smoking a lot, and smoking in movie theaters and smoking in cars.
Hello, Mary.
I heard you got stuck with babysitting duty this year. How'd you manage that?
Did this movie bring something specific back from your experience during the 70s?
Well, I remembered all the sort of cars and people smoking a lot and smoking in movie theaters and smoking in cars and stuff and all the clothing and all that stuff. I mean, I grew up around teachers and professors and stuff like that. So for sure, it was triggering unconscious and conscious memories about people like that, for sure.
I think you're erratic and belligerent, but you've got time to turn things around.
And I was going to tell you the same thing.
The Holdovers.